Good afternoon, all of you. This is Sarveshwar Reddy, working as assistant professor in St. Martin's Engineering College in SNH department. So today I'll demonstrate production. So what is the production? So if you want to run any company or any organization, suppose there is a service sector companies and production based companies. So even though in the service sector companies or production based companies, we require production. Production is one of the economic activity. It is an economic activity. Economic activity. Why we can say that economic activity? Because here, see, production, we said it's an economic activity. It takes some inputs and it will convert into outputs. So here, it includes that manufacturing, packaging, transport, storing, all these are the activities. So even though we can call factors of production. So what is the factors of the production? Here you can take the case, we have the factors. What are the factors of production? So factors of the production means here, man, money, material. We have material also. Material, man, money, material, land, labor, etc. and etc. So by using these things, these are the what inputs. We can take all these inputs and we can convert it into the outputs. So that is the reason we can say that it is in a production. It is in a production. And but we can use it some additional utilities of the good by chance from finance, place, time and services. So we can take it the place, time and services also. So these are very, very important concepts based upon the production. So this is the definition of production function. So next we can go through it, the next concept, the parameters. Okay, again the meaning that production, the production is the process of transforming into the various inputs. Already we discussed in the previous slide, land, labor, capital, organization into output. So what is that? Suppose you can take the case, whenever if you want to do any production activity, we require the land. Why? Because we need to construct the factory, in-house or out-house. So then we can take it, we require the labor. Human resource is one of the important capital for any organization. So next we can take it the case, organization. Organization means is nothing but what? There is a systematic hierarchy we have to build and we have to assign the individual tasks based upon their calibers. So that is the reason we can call these are the what factors or inputs into output. So already we discussed these things. Next we can go for the next concept. Okay, what is the production function? So technical relationship between the physical output and physical quantities of the inputs is referred to as a production function. An improved technology helps to the production, the given output within a lesser quantity inputs. So there is some mathematical relationship already I discussed here. So the natural resources, N means is nothing but what? You can take it in natural resources, it includes the land. We can call here what? Land. This is called what? Land. Already we can take land. So natural resources means is nothing but what? Land. We can take labor, capital. Capital. Capital means is nothing but what? Finance is an main engine for that any organization. Even though if you have the talent, you have the manpower, labor, and if you are having land, natural resource, and you are having technology. Why? Because based upon the technology. So nowadays the production process is automated means is nothing but suppose you can take it the case any car manufacturing company or any bike manufacturing companies. So all these companies, they are focusing on technology. Like suppose you can take it the case, I think you take it in a best example for Ford Motors in 1950s or 1960s. So they don't have conveyor belt system means is nothing but what? It is in a new technology introduced in the manufacturing side. So by changing the technology, Once you can change the technology, the companies adopted that same technology, then the production is also changed. Why? Because the production is changed. Whenever if you adopt the technology, then production is increased based upon the requirement, demand, based upon the demand in the market, fast processing of the production. We can finish the final goods within a in time or less time also. So that is the reason technology is also playing in a vital role. So the best example is what conveyor belt system in any manufacturing companies. So these are the what it is in a definition. Q means is nothing but what? Quantity of the production. Quantity of the production means is nothing but what? It is the output. So you can take it. Natural resources means land, labor, capital. Then we have that organization. Organization means is nothing but what? You can establish a business. So then technology. So these are the things for the production function. Next we will discuss after production function, we can go for the types of the production. So what are the types of the production here? So it's based upon short term and long run. Short run and long run productions we have, production functions. What is the short run? Short run means one variable input factor. So it means nothing but there is a number of inputs already we discussed in the previous slide. So what are the inputs we discussed in the previous slide? Suppose you can take the case land. We discussed the land, right? Land is also an input. Land, labor, capital, organization, technology. So these are the things we taken in the previous slide, and these are the variables. But here, one variable input factor means we will take only one variable is varies, and remaining all variables are constant. All these remaining things constant. We can keep it constant. So once you can keep it the constant, only one variable, any one variable. But I am taking an example here, like land is in a fix. But remaining variables are changing or whatever it may be. You can take it in a sum variable, make it in a constant, and remaining variables are varying. So that is the reason we can take it one variable input factor. Here there is a law of return. Then you can take it two variable input factors. So two variable input factors means it's nothing but again what based upon the cost, quantity. If suppose you can take it the case there is a raw material cost is increased. Once the raw material cost is increased, then automatically what happened? Producing final goods, the quantity we can reduce. Why? Because there is a raw material cost is increased. So due to this, we can reduce the quantity. Iso cost. Then we can take it the next one. Least cost combination. There is a mixing, manufacturing mix, not a product mix. Product mix means is a final product. We can take it in what? Least cost combinations. So we can go for the combination of inputs. Least cost combination. Suppose you can take it the case, maybe some areas like labor is very costly, labor is very expensive. So in few countries, like you can take it the case, Britain or Australia or some other countries, like you can take it that advanced developed countries, that countries are labor cost is more, labor are expensive. When there is a labor are expensive, technologies are cheap, they can take in a technology. So by using of technology, they will reduce the labor and they will take technology. So and again they can go for, is there any organization manpower is less, then they will combine. So least cost combination, MRPS. Next you can go for cube Douglas production function and long run production function. We have the long run production function. Under long run production function, we can take law of return to scale. What is the meaning of law of return to scale? See, whenever the company running long run, So what is that long run? Long run means like whenever if you establish in a company, the company maybe you focused on like next coming 10 years, then you are having a long visionary for the next 20 years or 30 years. Then you are not looking for that what? Returns, law of returns. Law of returns means is nothing but what? Short term you are not looking for the profits. You are looking for profits in the long run. Let it be, initially if you introduced any product, you are selling the product is very cheap. Why? Because you have to cope up the market, you have to concentrate on the new markets. At the same time, because you need to, you need to take forward direction towards to the company brand. Due to this, in the short run, you are not concentrated on profits. You are concentrated on the long run. So whenever you can concentrate on the long run, then you can go for long run production function. There is a only one production function, that is nothing but law of return to scale. Law of return to scale. Okay. Today's class, I will demonstrate one variable input factor. Under one variable input factor, law of returns, I will explain. Okay. What is the law of return? So, law of return means the proposition of one factor in the combination of the factors is increase after a point first, the marginal and then the average production of the factor will diminish. So what is the meaning of diminished? Diminished means decreasing. Decreasing. So decreasing. What is the decreasing here? Average production of the factor will be diminished. So some marginal factor, based upon the some marginal factor, the production will increase. Once it reaches in the some marginal factor, it will going for diminishing factors. Like the state of the technology is assumed to be in a given and under change. So what is the meaning of unchanged? Unchanged. So here the state of the technology, if the technology is assumed to be in a given unchanged, technology is not changed. Okay, you are keeping same technology, existing technology, and you are running the production. So this is the one assumption. There must be in some inputs was quantity to keep fixed. What is the quantity fixed here? Land is fixed. Land is fixed asset. So the law does not hold the situations where all the inputs are proportionally varied. So proportionally all the inputs are changing. Sometimes maybe the funding problem, the finance problem company is facing. At the same time, labor strike, manpower strike. At the same time, some technologies also change. All these proportionally change. So we consider only the physical inputs and outputs are not economic profitability in monetary terms. What is the meaning of monetary terms? Monetary terms means is nothing but here, we can take in the case finance. So finance is the monetary term. So we'll take it, this finance is the monetary term. So next here, law of returns. So what is the law of returns? Suppose you can take it the case here. Here I am taking units of labor. Units of the labor if I take. Suppose you can take it the case here. What is the units of labor? Units of labor we will take. So units of labor means is nothing but suppose you can take the case. Labor is varying, right? Labor is changing. So first zero labor, total production zero. There is a zero. Why? Because labor is varying here. This is called what? One variable input. One variable input production. So here, one variable production. One variable production function. Fine. What is the one variable production function here? So one variable is varying. So labor is varying. So labor is varying, it means labor is keep going on changing. So there is a zero labor. Once zero labor, total production is also zero, marginal production is also zero, average production. So we plot these values into the graph, total production, marginal production, average production. Then we can go for the stages, stage 1, stage 2, stage 3. See here you can take it the case, when there is a zero labor, there is a no total production. When there is a no total production, there is a no marginal production and there is a no average production. So next we can take it the case one variable. Okay, one input, one labor is increased. Labor is increased here. So labor from 0 to 1, I hire one labor in the company, then there is a total production is 10. Why? Because there is a only one labor. Now marginal production is also 10, average production is also 10. Next, if I take the two labors, then the production is increased. What is the production is increased here? The production is increased. So the production is increased, I produce 22 products. So here 12 is increased. 10 plus 12. So total 22. So whenever you can take it that way, 10 plus 12, 22. Here the marginal product. What is the meaning of the marginal product? Marginal product means is nothing but what? A difference between previous total production and current production. Previous total production and current production. So what is the difference here? You can take it the case 22 minus 10 equal to 12. So this is called what? Marginal production. This is called marginal production. So under this marginal production, then again you can take the case here. We have 22. Yes, 22. This is that marginal production. Then you can take the total production. Sorry, average production. Average production means is nothing but what? Here you can take the case. Total production. So suppose you can take the case first here, 10 plus 12. So this is I already discussed. There is a one variable. So under zero labor, there is a no production, total production. If whenever there is a zero total production, marginal production is also zero. When there is an average production zero, when there is a total production is zero, average production is also zero. Fine. Next, the company increased one labor. Once the company increased one labor, then production is also increased. So company has produced the 10 products. Marginal production is also 10. Average production is also 10. Next, when the company increased the two labors, then the production is total production is increased. So total how much it increased? 12 it increased. 10 plus 22. So 10 plus 12 means is nothing but 22. So here you can take the case. Marginal production. Marginal production means is nothing but here you can take 10 minus 22. 22 minus 10. Total how much? 12. So marginal production is 12. Next you can go for average production. So what is the average production here? The average production here you can take total production. Total production divided by number of labors. Number of labor. So if you take the total production by number of labor, 22 divided by 2. So how much? 11. 11 is the average production. 11 is the average production. If there is a 3 labor, if there is a 3 labors, company is increased, then total production is 32. Then 33 minus 22, marginal production we will get, it is called 11. Next year what? Average production means what? Total production. Total production 33 divided by 3 is called 11. Okay, then we got 11, this is average production. So like this we can keep going on calling. But after some stage, the production is keep going on. Here you can take the case. The total production is keep going on here. It increased, but after some time it keep going on diminishing. This is called diminishing. So here you can take the case until this stage the marginal production is keep going on increasing. Then we can consider this stage is stage 1. Here it is stage 1. Then after that marginal production is also on diminishing rate. So it's keep going on decreasing. So next year average production is also keep going on here diminishing. It's keep going on decreasing. So all these values we can plot on graph. So how we can plot? this is one thing I will discuss. Okay, this is the graph representation. Suppose you can take it the case here. The first thing, all TP, total production, marginal production, and average production. So everything is in that increasing rate. Increasing rate or not, it keep going on increasing rate, and in the stage 2 it keep going on what? Constant. Then after that it keep going on diminishing. So here next you can take the case, whenever here there is some relation, here you can take it the case, whenever there is an average production, average production it keep going on decreasing, then automatically once average production is keep going on diminishing, then marginal production is coming under minus, it coming under minus, negative.